I won a free trip to Mexico at age 9, and today we're going to talk about how I did it.
Let's get this vacation started!
Now, clearly at age 9, I wasn't entering contests on my own, but I was a very outgoing and curious kid. When my mom got an email from Sunwing Vacations, which is like JetBlue for you Americans, they were looking for a kidcation tester. So by definition, I'm not making this up, this is actually what it says on the website. A kidcation tester is a savvy, outgoing youngster under 16 who loves having a good time while on vacation, a dedicated youth who may be selected to be sent on a vacation to test out the coolest offerings, amenities, and other accommodations at select resorts in Sunwing's family collection, and a kid vacation reviewer. So my mom knew this would be the perfect job for me. So the first thing we had to do was submit a family photo along with the definition of why I should be the next kidcation tester. We waited very patiently over the next week or so while they sifted through countless entries from all across the country, deciding who they wanted to move on. We were shocked and excited when one day I got home and I saw we got an email from Sunwing saying that we were shortlisted to the top 10 in all of Canada. We now had only 4 days to get out and shoot my audition video. We were asked to produce a video reviewing the last resort we had traveled to, and it had to be a max of 2 minutes. Take note, at this point I was 9 years old and had never edited or touched any video editing software or a camera other than, you know, my little iPad and stop motion Lego. The next day, or probably even that night, my mom started writing a script for this video. We were then off to the airport, amusement park, ice cream shop, and beaches to simulate that we were in a resort in Jamaica, so all the different amenities that you could find there. Get it? Sorry, I know that wasn't good.
We went snorkeling almost every day. If water slides aren't your thing, check out this, the splash pad.
It took us probably about 10 million takes for me to get the lines right because I had one night to practice them and then we were filming the next day and you know. So we came home from recording this video on the latest and greatest from Apple at the time, which was the iPhone 6S, but now it was time for the hard part, actually editing this video and making it look like a finished product. We asked a family friend that had a little bit of experience editing to come over and help us with this, and she polished the video up and made it look great. Now we were just crossing our fingers and it was time to wait. But we all decided that even if we didn't win this contest, we had the absolute best weekend going out, filming, shooting all these different locations, learning a little bit about editing and just how a video gets produced. And it was sort of just a win-win either way. After we submitted the video, it was only about a week until my mom got an email in her inbox. I come home from school, she opens the... Whoops, hit my umbrella. She opens the door and goes, "Ty, we did it." And she actually got an email that said we were 1 out of 4 in all of the entries across Canada that won, and there were thousands and thousands of entries that they loved our picture and that they loved our video and that we were going to be going to the Azul Sensatory in Mexico to create a video. We all went absolutely crazy because never in our wildest dreams did we think we would win this. Before the trip, there was tons to do. Since they wanted to feature me in their magazine, they needed a ton of information for me for a complete 2-page spread. When we arrived at the resort in Mexico, there was 20 staff members lined up waiting to greet us. I was literally a little king just like walking up to my palace. They escorted us to our 3,000 square foot presidential suite where they introduced us to our personal butlers. Two of them actually. Personal cabanas and celebrity treatments every single day was quite an experience. Along with us, Sunwing sent a producer, Marcus, a videographer, Zane, and a photographer, Rob, to document the kidcation experience. I seriously had the time of my life watching these guys produce this video and take this basic idea of a story concept and transform it into this amazing production that looked like it was like TV level commercial wise. When I got back, I started making videos on my own, and if you want to hear more about how they inspired me and sort of how I got into photography, video production, and started my own company, you can click the video in the iCard, I don't know which side it's on, right here, and learn about how I started my business at 12 years old. A lot of the times you enter a contest and think, that's it, if I win, I win, if I don't, I don't, it's just luck, you know? But this was really a contest where we actually had to put in a ton of work to get the results, because we put a lot of work into that video, we put a lot of work into finding this very encompassing picture that made us look like a really fun family that we were gonna submit in the first place, right? Because without that picture, we wouldn't have gotten chosen. Without this video, we wouldn't have won, right? So it all goes together and encompasses, you know, sometimes hard work just delivers success, right? Because we didn't slack on this video. We put all we had into making this. And you know, a lot of the times, contests are just sort of, you know, a way of testing your hard work. It also shows that we never ever would have thought that we could win something like this, but there we were. We had the email that said we were going to Mexico, all expenses paid, and it was just insane. So one thing I want you to take away from this, and make sure you listen here, is that you never ever know when one single experience can be absolutely life-changing. Like, it's insane. I never thought by us submitting this picture to a little contest through Sunwing that it would be completely life-changing, open my eyes to the whole world of media production. I wouldn't be making this YouTube video right now, probably, if it wasn't for this trip. Who knows, but probably not. And that's why you have to be so open, like so open to doing anything that comes your way. Obviously, don't do anything dangerous, but you never know when doing one little thing can cause a big reaction and sort of change your life in so many different ways. So that's why it's important, even if you're going out of your comfort zone a bit, you're not comfortable with something, you're a little scared to do it, just do it, because you never, never, never know what it can do for you down the road.
So as I was talking about earlier, these are the magazines that I was in. So these are the Kidcations. This is 2015. I think this was one that came out just after. So here was before we went on the trip. This is just sort of a bio about me. I'll put a screenshot after so you can stop and read it. It says like things I like. This is my Kidcationer passport. So just a little bit about me, places I've visited, my must-haves when traveling. So that was just a one-page spread plus this quote from my dad. And then this was the actual big one after. So these are the pictures that we took on the trip. And this is sort of giving a whole breakdown of the resort, how they treated us, how the trip went. And this is actually an entire 4-page spread. You can see these were all the pictures that Rob took, the photographer. And it just sums up sort of how amazing our experience was overall. You can see over here, this is actually our stash of all of the magazines. There is a bunch of them because, you know, when it's the first time you're in a magazine, you kind of want to keep a lot of them. So that's really cool. I thought this was so cool. Quote, check out this, our own private pool. That was our private pool. It was pretty cool. So that's really awesome.
So I really just want to thank Sunwing for this amazing experience, and also thank my mom once again for entering me into this, because it was completely life-changing and amazing. But also thank you guys for watching this far to the end of the video. And if you do enjoy this type of content, make sure you subscribe right here and click this video right here to watch how I started my business at 12 years old. I was told that it was inspiring and that it's helped some other people. So go click that video, watch it, maybe it'll help you, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.